Mr. Rifat, we have last minute left quickly. Any predictions for the end of May, what the turnout's going to be like?
So, I mean, I've been absolutely affirmed that, you know, if, because there have been a lot of complaints about EVM and there have been a lot of question marks about, you know, about the malfunctioning of the voting machines. If that doesn't play a role, I cannot see, you know, Narendra Modi returning to power. I cannot see BJP come, you know, securing more than 170 to 180 seats, which will be down by more than 100 seats. So okay. If that happens, you know, despite, you know, Modi invoking religion and Hindutva and military, you know, I don't think, you know, BJP is going to come back to power.
Okay. Ms. Vidya, any predictions from you?
So what has happened now is that the BJP is falling short. I mean, it had reached saturation levels in 2014 in North India. There's no way it's going to be able to repeat that. In UP especially, it's losing seats because of the alliance against it. Mm-hmm. But what it is doing is trying to compensate this by going all out to take West Bengal and Orissa. Mm-hmm. And these are the two citadels that have been held by these regional leaders, Naveen Patnaik and Mamata Banerjee. They've been like impenetrable fortress kind of a thing. But the BJP this time has really mounted a huge assault. Mm-hmm. And they're hoping to try and make up some of the losses from North India. Mm-hmm. By gaining seats here. To what extent they will succeed, how many seats they will get, okay. And whether, I mean, it could be very difficult. Even if they manage to do well, it may not quite equal the losses they are suffering elsewhere. My own calculation is that the BJP, Narendra Modi, is definitely coming back, but not.
Definitely coming back.